Great news from Webflow. So I was scrolling through LinkedIn yesterday and I saw Alan's post telling us not to sleep on this one. He's right on this. So Webflow MCP server now supports the designer expanding way past the data API. Now, what does this mean? This means that you can now use the Webflow MCP to directly affect your project or do things inside your project, including the styles, the elements, and a lot of other things. So I'm going to show you how to set it up. Now, there is a way to set it up that is pretty unique. So we're going to go through this. We'll go to the link that Alan shared. So it's a announcement. So now it tells you Webflow MCP server now supports the designer. Great. And you can see here, they announced this companion app for the designer, which is amazing. Now you have this app that tells you, you know, you're using the MCP, you're using these tools on the MCP. And we're going to see it in action right now. So let's go to the installation guide. Now, this is the installation guide on how to install the MCP server on your project or on your computer. And first thing, you need to just make sure that you have the Node.js version 22.3 or higher. Now, to check this, you can just go to the terminal and you can write node/v, and this will tell you the version of Node that you have. And now, in my case, I have version 24.8, which is higher than the required, and that's great. And this is the latest version of as of today, but you just need to check and make sure you get this updated. Now, once you have that, you can go down to the installation guide. So here's how you install the MCP server on Cursor. You can also install it on cloud desktop. Now, if you have the desktop version of cloud, you can install this. Or if you have Windsurf, you can also use this. The installation varies between tools and you have to abide by the tools that are there. However, we're just going to do Cursor because I love Cursor. So now let's go open Cursor. So I'm going to get Cursor online. Now in Cursor, if you start, you can start a chat directly. Here you can start a chat, you can start chatting with it, you can also use the MCP. However, if there's no project linked to the chat goes away once you close Cursor, and you might not have it to refer back to it, which I really don't like. So I'm just going to open a project. You can just do that, create a new folder. This is test tutorial MCP, and we're going to open this file or folder. And now here, if we chat, if we do chats, we can refer back to them. They get saved in the history, so this is great. Now, there are two ways to install the MCP. One is creating a folder here. You can call it Cursor. And inside it, you can create a file called mcp.json. And this is a good way because then you have this only project focused. So this MCP only is project focused. The authorization is only for the certain project that you authorized. And this won't cause conflicts with other projects that you have. However, another way to do this is directly going to the settings and installing the MCP in your settings. So we're going to do this way because I have no projects. I have no different projects, so I'm just going to do the direct way. And we're going to go to add new MCP server. Now, in my case, I have another MCP. This is a browser MCP. It does something else. So I just want to add on top of that the Webflow MCP. So if I go back to the documentation, you can see here they have this script. And again, if you don't have any MCPs, you just copy paste this here. But in my case, I have something else. So I'm just going to copy this part, the Webflow part. And here I'm going to go add a comma and I will paste this in. Now, once I have this pasted in, let me close the other tab and I click save, control S. So we're saved. Now it's going to prompt me to authorize the website. So I'm just going to click approve and then I'm going to go to big template. So this is the project that we're going to be working on. And I always recommend that you authorize one specific project and not the entire workspace, because then you'll waste a lot of tokens, which can be inconvenient. So let's authorize this website. Let's say authorize app. All right, so authorizing is successful. You may close this window. Great, so let's close it. For some reason, it opened two windows, but let's close this one. So to check that it's connected, so I'm gonna refresh my website. So refreshing, it's taking its time. Now, this is a template from Bricks. Thank you, Bricks, for such a cool template. And this is what we're going to be working on. Now, to check if this is connected to the MCP, we're going to go to apps, or you can click E. And then you're going to see this new app called MCP, Webflow MCP Bridge app, and it says app installed here. So I'm going to click on the MCP app. And as you can see now, it tells me that I'm connected to an MCP server, which is great. So everything is working fine so far. Now let's go back to Cursor. And now we can start prompting. So I don't need this. I'm just gonna leave it here. So I'm just gonna start prompting here. Now, one thing I like to do is adding the Webflow documentations in my prompts or in my chat. You can go ahead and add a new documentation. I already have it. So if we go and add a new documentation, you just paste in a link, and you can find this link in this installation guide. If you scroll down to the end, you're gonna see they have this following link, developers Webflow LLMs text. And this is basically a breakdown of all the functions or the most used functions in Webflow regarding the API. So this can really help the AI understand what's going on and give you results that are Webflow oriented. I don't know why this is taking long. So if I open it in a new tab, you can see here they have this long description, which is great for the AI because it can read it directly without, you know, going through styles and whatnot. But let's go back to cursor. And now that we have this, we can start prompting. So first thing, I'm just going to ask it, what website are we connected to on Webflow, just to make sure that it knows what's going on, and it's going to check the MCP. It's going to know what website we're going to be connected to. So now, as you can see, it's calling Webflow guide tool. Now, just let's go back to the MCP server. So if I go to settings, I just want to show you the tools that we're using. So in this case, we're using, so there are these Webflow guide tool and ask Webflow AI. And these are a great tool because they can help the AI or your model have some guidance or have some place to ask for specific questions that it might have. This way it's not going to get lost, or it's not going to do stuff that are outside of Webflow's limitation, because it always has something to refer back to. Now, for some reason it's red here, and I think I just need to refresh. However, it's working fine because it's calling the tools. So in my case here, it's calling the sites list because I asked it for the name. So now it's gonna list the site that it has, and I'm gonna check which one we have, and it's gonna give me the name of it. So you can see it's reading the MCP JSON, clarifying Webflow connection. So it's doing the connection. So let's see what it's gonna give me. So now, as you can see, it says, I fetched your available Webflow website. So I'm connected to this big template website. It gives me the ID, it gives me the domain, it gives me everything I need to know. Even a preview link, I think this is a screenshot. However, now I know that my website's connected, we can start prompting to do things. Now, this is annoying me, so I'm just gonna, perhaps you turn it off and turn it back on. It's gonna go back to green. This is great. So now we're officially connected. Now, if I go back to the Webflow website, I just need to make sure that this bridge app is open so that we can easily have connections without any errors. So let's go back to the design, to the cursor. Say I want to change the body color to green. So I want to change all the text font color of the body to green. So I'm going to tell it, and then we're going to see what it does. The better you prompt, the better results you're going to get. Also, you can always set rule. Now, I'm going to show you this while this is working. So if you go to settings here in cursor, you have this thing called rules and memories. And you can set rules, specific rules that are maybe Webflow focused, that can help you during your workflow so that the AI doesn't go overboard or doesn't get out of the direction that you want to put it in. For example, I have a rule that says never publish or deploy websites via MCP without the user's explicit permission. And this helps me make sure that I don't have any situation where the site gets published automatically. Might be problematic at some point. So this is there. You can set your own rules here. Also, I also have the MCP to be manually run by me. So as you can see, every time it's calling an MCP tool, it's asking me, and I have to click run tool so that it goes. Now, of course, you can make this automatic. However, just make sure you keep an eye on what's going on. So we allowed this style tool to work. So let's see what it's going to do. So this style tool is basically what can affect styles on your website. So let's go back. Let's see if it changed anything yet. Not yet. So it's calling another tool. So it's calling it again. Now it does this where it, you know, analyzes what's going on. It calls the right tools. It analyzes the situation that it has. All right, one last one. So attempting to update the global body text color to green now. So first it analyzed the website, then it got the body, and now it's changing the color. So let's just move here. Ah, so it's already done. Let's go back to my project. So as you can see, I already have this green color. So if I go to body, and you can see body all pages, and the text color changed to green, which is, I mean, I know it's a simple use case, but you can imagine what else you can do with this. All right, so let's push this a bit further. Now, I started another chat, and as you can see, if you go back to MCP and integration, you can see the tools available here. There are a lot of tools that Webflow offers. These are the new ones that go in the designer. So you can see you have component tool, you have element builder, you have learn more about styles, style tool, and so on. So I want to add a component to the page. So let's go through our components. Let's see if we have a CTA, something like CTA or section. Okay, this template has specific stuff. So let's say card V1. So if I add card V1 somewhere in the project, say I add card V1 here. Okay, so this is card V1. Let's try to tell the MCP to add card V1 directly on our homepage. So add the component. Well, this is pushing it a bit further. I don't know if it's going to do this, but let's see. I mean, this is the whole point. We're going to test this out. All right, so now it's working. It's working. It's calling the MCP. So something happened. Missing required parameter, random script. Okay, so it's working through this. And I like cursor because, you know, if it goes to errors, it's just going to find out what it does. So identify target Webflow website to update. So just identifying the site, Webflow guide tool. So you can see here, because it kind of like got confused on what to do, it called the guide tool, which is great. So it can like figure out its own problems, try to solve them, and give me the result that I need. So here it's calling the site list. Let's see it. And it understood that we are on the big template site because I started a new chat. So the old chat was not referenced. So it's just going to start from scratch. All right, so now it's giving me page lists because I told it to go on the homepage. Components list, great. So it's getting the components. So far, so good. I'm just skipping the parts with the loading time so this video doesn't become long, but let's see what's going on. All right, so it's still calling some tools. The page tool is going to the homepage. So what page am I on? This is the homepage. All right, so it's on the homepage. Go back to cursor. Verify component card one exist. It's calling the component list again. And as you can see here, if I go here, you can see it's telling me the tools that we used. So some of the tools that we use directly, like page tool. I was testing around with variable tool, the style tool that we called in the beginning of the video. So you have this log here just to understand what's going on. So here you're calling element tool. And let's see how it's going to give us the result. Kind of called all the tools, and this is my mistake because my prompt was not that accurate. I just gave it a vague prompt. However, I just really want to test this out, see how much it can do. Of course, sometimes if someone is not that technical, has access to this, they can prompt some stuff and hopefully they get the results that they want while ChatGPT or any other model goes through this. Now, of course, again, you can set rules which can help you make better prompts, get better results without the AI getting out of the way. Let's go back. So it's calling component tool again, running it. All right, so now we have it. So we have our card V1 right here at the end, which I expected it to do. However, it is inside page wrapper, which is great. And that's what I asked for. It's not just directly thrown inside the body. It's inside the container that I asked for. And yeah, I mean, this is super cool, like super cool. So let's run this. So element tool, I think it's confirming that something happened. And as you can see, it says no publish because my rule was not to publish. Just make sure never publish until I ask it to. So now it's telling me that it's done. The card V1 is placed. Amazing stuff. Thank you, Webflow, for this amazing, amazing update. I can't wait to see what you guys are going to announce in the Webflow conference. I think this is going to be great. How much better than this can it get? I don't know. And I'm super excited to see how people are going to use this. Super excited to see some use case. I'm going to be using it a lot more now to see how much I can push and how much I can do out of my workflow because I use Webflow a lot. This is going to definitely increase the speed of how I process things and how I build things. Thanks for watching. See you later.